Hello students, welcome to class 6 maths chapter number 10 sets. Student, we have already started set chapter and today we will continue it. So what is set? Student, what is set? Set is a collection of well-defined object. Now what is well-defined object? So well-defined means it must be absolutely clear which object belongs to the set and which does not. So student, what we have studied in previous class, we have studied sets. What is sets? A set is a collection of well-defined object. And what do you mean by well-defined? Well-defined means it must be absolutely clear which object belongs to the set and which does not. Let us take example, vowels of English alphabet. Now student, you already know what are the vowels of English alphabet. So let's write down here. A, E, I, O, U. These are what your vowels of English alphabet. Now here, what is object in this? Object is English alphabet. English alphabets. And here well defined is what? A, E, I, O, U. Students, see here, in our example, vowels of English alphabet. Your object is English alphabet, which you can write down. Okay, you can list it. So that means it is properly well defined. So we can say that vowels of English alphabet is a set. As we can list the vowels of English alphabet, so it is a set. Now, each object of a set is called as element of the set, or we call it as a member of the set. Each object like A, A is what? Element of the given set. E is also the member of the set. I is the member of set. O is the element of the set. And U is also the element of set. So in a set, we are having 5 elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These 5 are the members of the set. And what is your set? Set is what? Vowels of English alphabets. So, got it student? Is it clear properly by the given example that in a set, which is object and whether it is well defined or not? And if it is well defined, then it is a set. And each object of a set is called an element of the set or member of the set. Let's see the properties of a set now. Now, the elements of a set are written inside a pair of curly bracket, or instead of curly bracket, we use the word brace bracket. Second point, each element are separated by commas. Third point, the name of the set is always written in capital letter. If the element of a set are alphabets, like A, B, C, D, then these elements are also written in small letters. The elements of a set may be written in any order. No element of a set must be repeated. Okay, student, these are your 6 properties of a set. First property is what? That whatever the element is there in a set, that should be written in a pair of curly bracket. Each element should be separated by commas, and the name of the set is always written in capital letter. And the element of set, if it is alphabet, then also it is written in small letter. We don't use here capital letter. And here order is not important. You may write down in any order, and the element should not be repeated. It should be written only once. Let us take an example. Now see here. We have already taken the example, the set of English, the vowels of English alphabets. So, what is the vowels of English alphabet? So, here what we are going to write down? First, we are going to give the name of the set. So, what we have given the name of the set here? A, which is a capital letter. Okay, now see, we have written here the vowels of English alphabets here. A, E, I, O, U. Now, this each elements are separated by commas, and it is enclosed in a curly bracket. order is not important here and element should not be repeated. This can be written in a different way also. Look here, I have given the name, not necessary that it should be A only. It can be any alphabet. Here I have written here like brace bracket and see here A. I have written here I, E, U, O. It should be, all the five elements should be there, but not necessary that order is important. So you can write down in any order, but it should not be repeated. Got it, student? How to write down? How to write down the set? First, we have to give the name of the set in a capital letter, like this way. This is the set, and we have given here name A, set A. Okay, then we have written all the elements which are enclosed in a curly bracket. This is curly bracket, and inside the bracket elements are written, and each element is separated by commas. It should be, it can be written in any order, but one thing that it should not be repeated. This thing you have to remember, and using these all properties we can write down the sets. Let's see here the Greek letter epsilon. For epsilon we write down like this way, like E. It is used for the word belongs to, or we can say that it is an element of. Okay, this epsilon means belongs to or is an element. Okay, now let's take one example. P epsilon A. It can be written as P. This epsilon means what? Belongs to A. So we write down here P belongs to A. Or we can say that P is an element of A. A is what here? Set, which is the name of the set here. We have given here name, which is written in capital letter. And this P is an element of this set A, or we can say that P belongs to A. Got it, student? What do you mean by this epsilon? This epsilon means what? Belongs to. Okay, now in set A means this set A, P is an element, means this P is an element of set A. Okay, now see here the symbol. Here epsilon is given and it is shown once, it has been cut. This epsilon, that means it does not belongs to, or it's not an element. Means we write down here epsilon and we cross it, that means it does not belongs to. Let's take an example. See here P, not what we say, P does not belongs to set A, or P is not an element of set A. Here we say P is an element of set A, or P belongs to set A. Here P does not belong to set A, or P is not an element of set A. Okay. Let us solve exercise 10B. Now question number 1. Now what is question number 1? If set A is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Means in this set A, we are having 5 elements. Which are they? 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. State which of the following statements are true and which are false. Let us check. Now see here, the 4 questions they have asked. This is what? Now what we say here? Belongs to our element. Let's check. 2 belongs to A. Okay, where is your A? Set A, this. Okay, in this set A, 2 is an element? Yes, 2 is an element. So we'll write down here that first one, 2 epsilon A, we want to find out whether the statement are true or false. So it is true. Why it is true? Because as element 2, this 2 belongs to the given set A. See here, 2 is there in set A. Now let's take 5 and 6 belongs to A. Now look here, 5 and 6. If this 5 and 6 is there in set A, yes, 5 and 6 is there in set A. So we say that 5 and the 6 belongs to A. So your answer is here true, as element 5 and 6 both belongs to the given set A. Okay student, you have understood this? This sign means belongs to, and these are the elements, and this is what your set. Okay, let's come to the next one. 3, 4, 7 belongs to A. Let's check. 3. Yes, 3 is there. 4 is there. But this 7 is not there in the set. That means the statement is false. Very good. Why we say as element 7 does not belong to the given set A. Look here, student. 7 is not there in set A. Okay, that's why your answer is false. Come to the next one. Now, student, just tell me whether this belongs to A. Here is written 2 and here is 8. 2 is there? Yes, 2 is there in set A. But 8 is there? No, 8 is not there. That means your answer statement, this given statement is false. Why it is false? As element A does not belong to the given set A. Understood this question number 1? Okay, come to next one. Question number 2. Now, what is your question number 2? That if set B is 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. This is set B, and in this set B, these are the elements. State which of the following statements are correct and which are wrong. Let's see. Now, the first one is given. 5 belongs to B. Now, student, just tell me this 5. 5 belongs to B means what? 5 belongs to B or 5 is an element of B. Let's check whether 5 is there. Is it 5 is there in this set B? No, 5 is not there. That means this statement is wrong. Come to the next one. 12 belongs to B. Okay, student, 12 is there in the set B? Yes, 12 is there. 12 belongs to set B. That means this statement is correct. Let's check. 40 belongs to B. 14. 14 is the an element? Yes, it is an element. So, this statement is correct. 9 belongs to B. Okay, 9 is there, student, here? No, 9 is not there. That means this statement is wrong. Let's write down your first 4. Now, see, 5 belongs to B. Yes, it is wrong. Why? As element 5 does not belong to the given set B. Let's write down 12. Yes, 12 belongs to B. 12 is an element of B. Yes, correct. So, you will write down element 12 belongs to the given set B. Third one. 14 belongs to B. 14. 14 is an element here. So, answer is correct. Then write down 14 belongs to the given set B. And the fourth one is 9 belongs to B, which is wrong because 9 is not an element or it does not belong to the given set B. Now, students, see here the fifth one. What is given? B is the set of even numbers between 2 and 16. Now, 2 and 16. What is between 2 and 16? Which number comes? Even number. So, after 2 comes, between is given, so 2 and 16 will not be considered. So, it will be inside this 2 numbers. So, 4, yes, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12. 12 and 14. So, these all elements are given in the set B. Means B, if you consider B, so you are having your number between 2 and 16. So, your answer this is correct. Now, come to the next one. 4, 6 and 10 are the member of the set B. Let's check. 4, 6 and 10. Yes, they are the member of the given set B. That means this statement is also correct. That we will done in the next one. See, B is the set of even number between 2 and 60. Your answer is correct because all the elements belongs to the given set B. And the next one is given. 4, 6, 10. Yes, 4, 6, 10 are also the member of set B. So, your answer is correct. We'll write down all the element 4, 6, 10 belongs to the given set B. Okay, student, you have understood this question number 1 and question number 2. I hope you have understood the sign like E. E means epsilon. Epsilon means what? Epsilon belongs to or it is an member element of the set. It belongs to or it is an. Come to the question number 3. State whether true or false. Now look here. Sets 4, 9, 6, 2 and in this set 6, 2, 4, 9 are not the same. Okay, student, according to our rule, the elements are same. Are the elements same here? Look here, 4, 4, 9, 9, 6, 6, 2, 2. In this both the set, elements are same. Though the orders are different, but elements are same, but it is given not the same. So your answer is false. Let's come to the next one. Sets 0, 1, 3, 9, 4, 4, 1, 0. Both are having same element and here are written same. So your answer is true. Come to the next one. Sets 5, 4 and 5, 4, 4, 5 are not the same. If you see student, according to our property, the element should not be repeated. As the element should not be repeated, here it is repeated. If you write down this once again, it will be like 5 and 4 only. This is also 5 and 4 and here also it will come 5 and 4. That means this both are same, but what it is given, they are not the same. So that means your answer is false. Why it is false? Because they are having same element. What we are going to do? We are not going to write down this. We are going to write down this 5 and 4 only once. It should not be repeated. So this is wrong here. This we will correct it and we'll write down here 5 and 4 only. That means they are same and here it is given not same. So we have written here false. Are you getting, student? Let's see the next one. See now, 8, 3 and 3, 3, 8. Are they same? Yes, they are same. Why they are same? Because here we are having two element, 8 and 3. Here also we are having two element. Why we are having two element? Here 3 and 3 repeated. According to our property, it should not be repeated. So we'll consider only 1, 3. 3 and here 8. 3 and 8. They are same. So your answer is true. Now, collection of vowels used in the word Allahabad form a set. Okay, vowels. In this vowels, vowels what is there? A is there. So we can write down here as a set. So your answer is true. Not necessary that all the vowels should be there in alphabet, but there is a collection. What is the collection in that? A means in this set we are having only one element. Come to the next one. If P is the set of letter in the word roof, R-O-O-P, roof, then P, here P is given the set, P is equal to, see student, this is given alphabet. This we are going to write down in a small letter. Now look here. R. R is given. O. O is also there. Again O is there, but it is repeated. So here we are not going to write down. And P. P is also there here. That means here. How many letters will be there? Members. P. O. R. That means your answer is true. Come to the next one. If M is the set of letters used in the word Mumbai, then M is equal to. So what we are going to write down? M, here M. U, we have written here U. Now M is repeated, so this we will not write down. So come to the next one. B, B. A, A. I, I. That means this set which we have written from the given, it's true. Okay, student, you have understood this? State whether true or false. The question is what? Our question number 4. Write the set containing. Now we want to write down the set. See, first is given the first 5 counting number. Which are the counting numbers, student? When we start counting, we start from 1, 2, 3, 4. So what is our rule? We want to write down the set. We have to remember first what should be given. To the set, name should be given. So I have taken here A. Not necessary that it should be A. You can take any alphabet, but it should be in a capital. Okay, then we have written here curly bracket, or we can say brace bracket. It has been closed. It has started. And inside this bracket, we are going to write down first 5 counting numbers. So first 5 counting number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and each these elements are separated by commas and the elements are not repeated. So using the property of set, we have written thus first 5 counting number. Come to the next one. What is given here? The 3 types of angle. Student, you already learned what are the types of angles. Okay, student, tell me what are the types of angles? on, write down what we'll give. First name we'll give. Okay, B I have taken here. Then bracket, and inside the bracket we are going to write down three angles, which are they? Right angle, acute angle, and obtuse angle. See here, we have separated by commas, and this is three type. One type, second type, and three types. Three types of angles we have in curly bracket, and not necessary. You can write down first here acute angle, obtuse angle, and acute angle. Either you take here acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle. Order is not important here, students. Okay, come to the next one. The three types of triangle. Now, which are the three types of triangle? You student, you have already studied in previous class. Come on. Okay, I have given here the name C. Equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle, and scalene triangle. See here, separated by commas, and it is not repeated. It is written only once. Come to the next one. The member of your family. Now look here, students. In the member of your family, everybody's are different. So in such case, you can write down either your father, you can write down father name, mother name. If you have brother, write brother name. If you have sister, it's not given that you have to write down only 1, 2, 3, 4. How many members are there in your family? That much you can write down. I have just taken here one example. Like you can write down here your own mother's name, father's name, brother. If you have, write down brother one, brother two, brother. You can write down your sister's name. You can write down and yourself. These are what your members of your family. You can write down by your own. Come to the next one. The first six consonant of the English alphabet. Okay, you know the vowels. How many alphabets are there? 26 alphabets are there. Okay, out of that 26 alphabets, 5 are vowels, A, E, I, O, U. Leaving that vowels are your consonant. But we are going to write down first 6. Starting first 6 we are going to write down. So what we'll do, I have given your name and C. B, C, D, then E will not come, F, G, H. These are what your first 6 consonant of English alphabet. Got it, student? Come to the next one. The first 4 vowels. Okay, student, you already know and I have taken the same example. Come on, what are they? But we want to write down only 4. So we have written A, E, I, O. 5th one we have not written because they have asked first 4. So only 4 we have written. Come to the next one. The name of any 3 Prime Minister of India. Any student, any Prime Minister of India you can write down. Here I have written Narendra Modi, Dr. Manmohan Singh, and Atal Bihari Vajpayee. You are not going to suppose to write down here and here only. The element should be separated by commas. Okay, student, you understood how to write down the set from the given statement. Next one. Next question is 5. What is in question number 5 given? Write the member or element of each set given below. Now look here. Now this set is given. Okay, student, why I am saying this is set? Because these are elements and these elements are enclosed in a bracket. When any elements are enclosed in a bracket, that means this is a set. When bracket is there, brace bracket, that means it is a set. Now we are supposed to write down only member. We don't want to write down set. Set is given, we write down the member. So what will be the answer of this? So your answer is 3, 8, 5, 15, 12, and 7. Now we have not used your bracket. If I use bracket, then it will become your set. But we want to write down set is given from set. We want to write down member. So these are the member of this set. Now come on, student, can anybody tell me this? What we are going to do? We are just going to remove this bracket and this remaining are your members. So we are going to write down C-M-N-O-S. These are the elements of this set, given set. Come on, next one, B. Write the set whose members are given. Now members are given, totally reverse. Now this is given and you want to write down this. Now what do you want to write down? Set. When we want to write down set, that means there should be a brace bracket, curly bracket. So see here, in the first one, they have given the members. Now what we are going to write down? We are going to write down set. Now what we are going to do here? We write down in a curly bracket, and this all the elements are separated by commas. Next one, same as it is, same numbers we will write down and we'll enclose in a bracket. I hope, student, you have understood this, how to write down the set and how to write down the member from the given set and how to write down the set from the given member. Next, we will continue in our previous class. Till that, thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.